Hello. So I'm playing the new Kerbal. Let's go ahead and get a moon base. So the new Kerbal has directed play, and that means it's not quite as much fun as I originally had when I was playing Kerbal the first time. And it's not quite as much fun as playing with your own mods, but on the plus side, it is directing me to do things that I wouldn't have considered doing just because they make no sense, like randomly flying across large patches of ground or putting down a base on the moon that doesn't have any actual function. So this does have a bit of directed play here that might be good for people who aren't naturally interested in putting star bases around every single planet just because that's what you do. But this is the first time it's asked me to create a moon base, so I figured, okay, I'll create a moon base, a land base on the moon. It has to have spots for 7 Kerbal, but it doesn't have to have 7, it just has to have that many spots, so I've only got 3 actual people aboard my B string, and that should be enough. I think you'll like the design of the ship. And right now, we're about to enter our asparagus staging area. As always, asparagus staging is something that's a little bit delicate, but works great. So this is the part where the ship might spin a little bit, but that looks pretty decent. Time to do our gravity turn. I didn't tie it up quite as well as I might have, but that's okay. We just got to bring it under control and try not to waste all of our RCS there. Looks like our sound went out. How magical. So we'll just go ahead and continue our operation to get us into space. We're not in a particular hurry to get to space. We've got more than enough thrust, and when these engines are gone, we'll be able to thrust reliably. Like that. Perfect. Alright. Looks like we actually ended up burning a lot of fuel in an awkward way, but that's okay. We got enough fuel. We just want to get to the moon. Now, a nice low orbit is great if you've got enough thrust to bring your entire ship to bear. Obviously, this would be very, very dangerous if we were a low-thrust vehicle, but since we are an extremely high-thrust vehicle, we'll just go ahead and, from here, go straight to the moon. And we got loads of thrust, as you can see. It's more efficient to do this thrust when your orbit is low rather than when your orbit is high, so that's what we're doing. The area we're going to be landing on is near the southern pole of the moon. And it looks like we might have jumped the gun a little bit, but it's not too bad. Oop, that'll work. In case you're wondering about that flipping back and forth, that's a bug in Kerbal. Usually it ends up actually being the wider of the two orbits. So we're just kind of waiting for us to pop into the moon's sphere of influence. Any second now. There we go. So there is our landing zone. And that means we got to go west a lot. And south. Not quite nearly as much. Alright, here we go. West. And south. Oh, That's way too much south and not nearly enough west. I don't know why I got my west and my south backwards for some reason. Didn't I? So what I just did is I ran out of electricity because I forgot to extend all my solar panels. So let's go ahead and extend them now. Not the two that are directly under the engines, I don't recommend that. But the other ones should do fine. There we go. Now we've got our electricity back. Let's go ahead and turn to the proper angle, which is pretty much straight west now. We got the southwardness we needed. We're not going to go into orbit around the moon or anything like that. We're just going to drop straight down onto our target. These are the things you can do when you pack enough fuel. Something like that. And you notice that we've burned about 95% of our primary stages here, but that should be fine because we're going to ditch them and we'll still have our Skyhook stage left, as long as we don't have any problems with our Skyhook stage, which is possible. Skyhooks are notoriously fickle. Or Sky Crane, if you prefer. Whichever. Ooh, we're actually short. That's not a big deal. Okay, here we go. We are now entering the area where we would like to start to think about braking. I really wish the markers would show up in this view, but they don't. So you can see we're coming in pretty fast. We're already going 700 meters per second and we're still above 150,000. We do want to be careful. We have got plenty of fuel, but our thrust is going to drop from incredibly nice to incredibly poor in about 3 or 4 seconds here, 3 or 4 seconds at 100%. So we have to be careful not to do too much damage to our altitude. We need our altitude to be good. That needs to be... Sorry, I'm trying to land and think at the same time, and I just realized we're short, and there's a couple other details, so we're trying to control our speed while also not spending too much fuel and not doing it too high, because if you do it while you're too high, you are inefficient, and, you know, that ought to do. So we're just going to go ahead and bear with this. And we're going to probably be quite late when we start to thrust for real, because I want the high efficiency. So maybe 80,000 or 70,000, something like that. That'll do. So now let's start to burn off some of this ridiculous speed before we get so close that we die. Alright, so we're now out. Switch over to our Skyhook stage, and you can see how that still decelerates us, but it's not nearly as nice. We've also got some problems with the Skyhook stage being finicky. So I'm never sure why some of these stages are more finicky than the others. This is a parallel object. I mean, there's nothing on the left that's not also on the right, so I'm not sure why it suddenly catches and starts to tip. See how it's catching and starting to tip? It's so weird. So this is about the fastest we can decelerate safely, which means that we do have to be burning now. We can't wait. doesn't really matter where we put down, as long as we put down somewhere. Let's go ahead and put on some lights here. And there we are, twisting again. Alright, so that's plenty slow. And we got lots of time left before we touch down properly. And you can see we're actually quite a bit short of our destination, so we could always burn in this direction. But it'll be a while before we have to worry about anything. Let's go ahead and... I guess we just want to burn pure south. We don't need to burn offset. And we'll burn at a low grade so that we don't have any spin problems. Actually needing to go a little bit east. Not a big deal. There we are. Now this is a pleasant flight down, assuming that we don't crash and explode and die. I was actually hoping that this would be a lot more difficult. But it looks like I built this okay. I don't know what that engine was catching on, but it was only a little bit of a catch, rather than a complete blockage, so it didn't end up causing us to crash. The only real question remaining is whether or not we have ground that we can actually land on. There is a real risk of us having nothing but boulders or something. Craters. But in this case, we are landing on top of a mission destination, and I think that that's on a flat plane. We're going to see pretty soon here. Oh, we're going to come in short again, aren't we? I really keep underestimating just how far we are. It's hard to see because the dots are not where they should be. See how difficult it is to tell? And if they appeared on this map, it'd be a lot easier to tell. Alright, let's drop some speed here, or drop some altitude here, gather some speed. And if we take a look down, the light's just coming up and we can see that we are in fact headed for a flat point. Go us. Now we gotta bleed off some of the speed for real. This height is 3,000, 3,500 maybe? We'll find out. If it's 6,000, I'm going to be in trouble. It's like 3,000. We got lots of fuel though, so we might as well spend it. Still can't see any of the surface. Dark. I thought the sun was going to come up just as I was landing, but looks like I was a little too early, and we are just landing in a giant vat of black. Oh, I think I can see it. Yeah, it's resolving now. Wow, this part of the moon looks really rocky. Is this actually flat? Yeah, okay. They must have changed the moon texture. This is the first time I've landed in 0.9. Alright, so that means that we are all settled down. Let's shut down these engines. And extend our final set of panels. And let's take a look at our base. So this is the base that I've built, and it is not facing into the sun like I had kind of hoped it would be. I might have enough power to actually rotate it, but let's save before we do that. No, I don't. That's fine, though. It's okay not facing into the sun. And it has a cupola and two of these Mark II crew cabins, so it can have a total of 9 people in it. It's also got, suspended here, a car, which for some reason is pointed the wrong direction, but that's okay. Not a big deal. I can always turn the car around. So let's go ahead and get a little bit of sunlight here. There we go. And then we will detach the car. Turn on our brakes. Don't want to drift away. It does have a control node that's separate from, it doesn't require humans. So when we take our car around, we're going to want a pilot, and that's Lodzor. Did we extend this ladder? No, there we are. Extend it, please. Well, whatever. Not that patient. Boom, 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 boom. Boom, 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 boom. We want the pilot because the driving does involve some SAS, but we can also use some of our scientists. We're actually going to want to EVA everyone. Was this a scientist? Luke. I think he was a scientist, or was he the engineer? Well, let's put him in the chair. And then we have our last Kerbin, who is Hardorf. I think he might be the scientist. But anyhow, we're going to go ahead and put him in the control seat of the ship, just so that there's someone to talk on the radio with. Of course, if it turns out that he's the scientist, that's not going to be too great. Actually, don't know how I can tell. Well, whatever. So here you can see our two little dudes. And let's turn off our brakes, and let's drive just a little bit away here. Aha! You see how I got that tip problem. Trick is to go into docking and use the linear mode, and that way it will behave itself quite nicely. So we've got our seismic data from the moon's Midlands, and we've also got the thermometer from the moon's Midlands, neither of which we have before, but that's okay. We're not going to be going anywhere other than the Midlands with this vehicle, so it is, not something where we have to worry too much about going back. Oh, come on. They really need to make it easier to do this. Alright, now did I just deactivate it? I'm such an idiot. Alright, so we are just going to drive straight for it, which we can do by looking at the little marker and going. Now, when it comes to buggies, this buggy is small and frail and likely to die, so we need to be careful not to screw up. However, it is so slow doesn't do anything very fast that we can actually put out our solar panel while we're driving, because we're not going to probably break 10 meters per second. If we do, that's extremely dangerous, and we need to actually slow down quite a bit. because these wheels are shitty. But I couldn't fit anything bigger on this mission. So this is a mission where two brave Kerbals set out across the terrain. Yeah, you might as well take a surface sample and get an EVA report. I think I brought along the engineer. That might end up being fine because these wheels, I can repair them if they break. I'm a little bit worried about what this is. Is this a drop? I can't friggin' see. I think it's flat. Just a tiny shadow. Oh, stop. So now that we're here, we have to take a sample. Log seismic data. But notice that it's all Midlands, so we can just keep taking a sample over and over and over. We don't have to worry about going back to the ship each time. But there's one of our samples. Let's move on to the next one. And you can see that it's over to the left, so let's turn and go that direction. This is really great. Of all of the 0.9, you know, I do a lot of complaining about the way Kerbal is going because I like undirected games a lot more. But this is the sort of thing that I really like to see. I'm actually getting use out of a moon buggy, and it's a really crap moon buggy. So it's great to have that built into the game. What I think I would have probably preferred is if these hotspots just showed up. And you didn't have to like take missions or anything. It was still so totally self-directed. So you would have these just randomly showing up in the game world. That might have been a little bit better for my preference, but you know. This is still quite nice, and I'm still getting use out of my buggy for once in the universe. Up, there's the beta. Let's break. And we need to take another one of those samples. It's actually quite easy because we don't have to broadcast them or anything like that. We just have to click on them, and then we can overwrite them later on if we want to. So the fact that buggies now have a use, at least a little bit of a use, is great. The only problem is that these missions are actually a little bit pricey in terms of having to launch them. The only way I could afford to launch this seismic mission with a buggy attached to it was by attaching it to the much larger moon base mission. And of course the moon base is useless, I'm never going to use it again. I might rescue these people, and there's some fuel left on it, so you know I can charge up again, but it's a little bit of a shame that they can't figure out a way to make space bases as useful as buggies in this new era of buggies not sucking. Alright, we're going a little bit fast here, so I'm going to just hit back and try and slow us down. There we go, that's fine. Doop doopy doop doopy doopy doop 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 doop. Oh, I know what I'm missing. I uninstalled that, I uninstalled all the mods. I don't have a mod manager at the moment, so my mods, I'm not going to install any until I find some. But there was that really great Chatterer mod, which makes these kinds of rides a lot more interesting and fun. That was a little bit close. Let's, not have that problem. Still the Midlands, that's fine. So, if we look at the map of the moon, we have cleared this area. We do have some other things we would like to measure over here, but this is a different set of missions, and I can't really do it with a buggy, even if I could drive that far. So all we're going to do is go back home. Back to our moon base. It's only a kilometer away, but it sure feels like longer when we're driving something this slow. If your vehicle can't sustain 20 kilometers an hour when going uphill, there's just no point. Sorry, 20 meters a second. Is this downhill somehow? I guess it is. That's fine. We're gonna go uphill real soon here, so a little bit of extra speed won't hurt us. Bleed off some speed by turning. And we're home. Well, very near. The beta team did extremely well. And we have the ability to broadcast stuff from that particular area. We should probably get this temperature filled in. They're so, you know, bundled up shoulder to shoulder. Not very much room in this buggy. I haven't had to build a vanilla buggy in a long time. It's still pretty crap. Okay. So one of the things we have to remember is that the buggy actually blocks the entrances if we redock it. So before we redock it, we're going to have to get out and go inside the base. This thing does have RCS. I didn't have to ever use it until that last second, but it does. So let's leave our seat. Oh, bonk. You too. Leave your seat. Might as well go in the same place. You could have your own room, but that would get really lonely, because I'm going to leave you here forever. Perfect. And now you, with your automated systems, will remote control you from inside of the ship, and have you just pilot yourself safely up until we can dock. So we're going to control from here, and we're going to control from here, and we're going to try and get these aligned a little bit. And you can see that they are not terribly aligned. So we'll turn on our RCS and burn to the left. Oh, we're going to put on our brakes. I think that's probably for the best. So is it control? Yeah, control. Alright, so is it up? Up. Oh, damn it. Control. Unfortunately, the thing is on backwards, which is not what I had wanted to do. So, now we're in more or less the right spot. Let's go ahead and retract our landing gear. Which may not... Well, first things first, let's close this away. We might need this later, and it would be a real shame if we broke it. And... clunk. There we go. Perfect. Everything is aligned. Last thing to do... broadcast all that science. So this is how I built a moon base. My moon base had a skyhook system because I like being close to the ground. You can easily land that, you know, a moon base like a lander, And I also could have made the skyhook detach and fly away, but I figured maybe someday I'd need the fuel. Who knows? So we've got a little bit of fuel left here, and a base that works fine, works perfectly. Still a fully functional rover. All that science is gotten, and everything is golden. And of course, we, hello? What? Did you crash when I clicked on that? I'm gonna get pretty upset if you crash now. Well, I guess I quick-saved it recently. Well, anyhow, this frozen system here, these are complete. You can't even see my mouse anymore. Oh, there we are. Well, that was weird. Alright, so we completed those. We haven't measured any of the temperature stuff yet. But here's our outpost. Landed the outpost, have the docking ports, have the facility supporting 7 Kerbals, viewing cupola, and maintain stability for 10 seconds. So we're done with all of the missions we set out to do. And, of course, we're going to just go back to the Space Center. Interesting that revert flight was still an option. Did they enhance that so that you can revert flight even after changing focus? Neat. We didn't actually make any money. We didn't lose any money either. We made, like, maybe $100,000, because that mission was expensive. And you just barely broke even, because I haven't really balanced the missions yet. But we did make enough money to finish researching everything that we can research, which isn't much, because I need $3 million for the rest of this stuff. Anyhow, my verdict on Kerbal 0.9, it's pretty good, I suppose, but it's not as open or free as I would have liked it to be. Fundamentally, the act of putting restrictions into the game changes it to a progression-based game rather than an exploration-based game, which is just less interesting to me.